All right, let's take a look at division of decimal numbers. What we're going to show you is how doing division of decimal numbers really comes down to division of whole numbers, because you can always adjust the powers of 10 to get you the division of decimal numbers you're interested in. Let's look at the first one, 2.88 divided by 1.2. We can rewrite it. Remember how you know how to rewrite this as 2.88 over 1.2. And now this is just like reducing fractions. So let's rewrite it. We have 2.88. So let's multiply top and bottom by 100, which is 10 squared, right? 10 times 10. So that will give you 288 on the top and 12 times 10 on the bottom. So doing this division really comes down to doing the division of 288 over 12. And then just remembering to multiply by a tenth, which is same as moving one decimal over. So you can see 288 over 12, you already know how to do that. Equivalent fractions, 12 goes into that 24 times. You can factor it and reduce it that way. Either way, when you reduce it to 24, you have to remember to multiply by 1/10, which is the same as saying it's 24 over 10, or moving the decimal place one to the left. That will give you 2.4. Let's look at 2.88 divided by 0.0012. Do the same thing, so rewrite it. And now multiply numerator denominator by 10 to the 4, because 1, 2, 3, 4, that's the largest number of places. Here we have 1, 2. So 10 to the 4, and now when you do that, look, 288 over 12 again, except this time you have to remember to multiply by 100. So decimal number division is nothing different than doing whole number division, but then making sure you're adjusting the decimal point. So again, 2400 then, because 24 times 10 squared, which is 2400. How about just 288 over 12? Well, then that would just be factor it and rewrite it, which is what I was telling you before. You can just reduce it and that gave you 24. How about that? Rewrite it and factor the numerator, divide like terms, and there's your answer. How about that? We already saw that when you have fraction divided by fraction, it's the same as fraction multiplied by reciprocal. So numerator here became denominator here became numerator. Now what? Make formulas on the column, factor everything, and then reduce. We'll give you a few moments. Pause the video here. Are you pausing? It's a good review of factoring. Okay, so the numerator over here, x squared minus 9, is difference of squares, so those are the factors. Product is 4x squared. Two numbers multiplying to give you 4x squared, adding to give you 2, that's not going to happen. Difference of cubes, so that factors. Two numbers multiplying to give you 6, adding to give you negative 5, so that will be negative 2x minus 3x, factor by grouping. All right, let's put all the factors together, multiply all the numerators, multiply all the denominators, and then reduce. So x minus 2 and x minus 2, x minus 3 and this x minus 3, and this trinomial with this trinomial. And you're left with just x plus 3 over 1 or x plus 3. So again, even though it looks complicated, it really is not anything different than what you've already been doing. Try that on your own. Pause the video, please. Again, factor everything. Remember, whenever you're factoring, pull out the greatest common factor out first, and then factor the trinomial or binomial as the case might be. So first, rewrite it. Rewrite it how? This fraction times the reciprocal here. So that will become numerator, that will become denominator. That's why they've gotten flipped. All right, so let's do formulas only. Pull out the greatest common factor, difference of squares. So Remember how to factor difference of squares? So 2p will go here and here. Q will go here and here. How about that one? Factor that one on your own. Pause the video. Okay. Two numbers multiply, give you product of these two, which is negative 15, adding to give you plus 2, so that'll be that. What can you pull out of those two? A p. So 3p plus 5q, 3p plus 5q. So you'll have to put negative q out there. Negative q times 3p is negative 3pq. Negative q times positive 5q is negative 5q squared, and then factor the remaining. Let's factor this next one, same way. Remember, if you're stuck on factoring, you may want to go back and review factoring lectures. This last one, pull out the greatest common factors, and then it's difference of squares. So we're going to have a P and a Q here. Put all the factors together and then just start reducing common factors. And then the leftover is your answer. All right. Try these on your own.